Welcome to the Windsor Performing Arts Academy's The History of Windsor. Thank you so much for coming. It's not very much fun to give a gift if someone doesn't accept it. And these kids and grown-ups who've been working on this play for tens and tens of hours are so excited that you're here. Please turn off your cell phones so that nothing interrupts your journey into the past. Whether you moved here this morning or we're here in 1911, when Fred Wiseman and John Peters built their the world's first airplane that flew airmail, everything will affect you. Everything you see here is connected to a web of families who love each other and love their community, their traditions and policies that continue to be part of present-day Windsor. It's certainly not a comprehensive documentary, and I know I haven't mentioned many people who deserve acknowledgement, but then we would be here for 10 hours, and that wouldn't be fun for anyone. It's a simple and best effort love offering to my town, and my hope is that when your journey is through, you will want to be a part of this great Windsor family, that you will want to join with the organizations that serve in Windsor or in any capacity that you can. So let's focus on the great things that we've been, the great things that we are now, and the great things we can be as we explore the history of Windsor. I remember growing up what is now called Windsor. We would come down from the foothills to harvest the buckeye from the trees on the Ridge Ranch. Our parents taught us how to find the food the land gave to us and how to prepare it. We learned to take care of each other and to serve each other. We were the first families in Windsor.
Thank you. restaurant.
Folks would stop by this well on their way to from Hillsburg and Santa Rosa and beyond.
Windsor's a place to raise your family.
Dispensation from the Masonic Lodge in the Township of Windsor. They received their charter in October of 1866.
Soon they built a second floor in the bell tower on the old schoolhouse near the town where for their meetings.
They also leased the space to the Odd Fellows and Foresters Clubs for their meetings.
In the 1870s, the railroad came through town and changed everything. In the 1890s, the old yellow church was dismantled and moved nearer to the train station. All aboard!
Road.
taught them how to work and translated for them when necessary. I must say, the surveillance was pretty lax.
I'll say their surveillance was lax. One day, a squad of us prisoners was out working on a local farm, attended by a single American guard. The guard, with little fear for his normally docile charges, decided to take a stroll to see his gal in Windsor Town. He leaned his rifle against a tree and dropped his ammo belt, too.
When it was time for us Germans to head back to camp, we were surprised. Our guard was nowhere to be found. We searched the orchard and found his rifle and ammo belt, but he was still missing. Well, as responsible as we were, we took the weapon, marched back to camp, and turned the gun into the authorities before letting ourselves back in. No joke, and no great escape here.
Yep, prisoners can come and go as they pleased and thought Windsor was awesome.
Not always as we pleased. One day, two German prisoners were found missing. The camp commander launched a massive search. Soldiers, policemen, and who knows what else scoured the countryside looking for the fleeing Nazis. When they were finally found and arrested, they were asked why they had fled the normally quiet facility, and they replied,
As long as we were here, we wanted to see the Pacific Ocean.
They also had a soccer team and a band that I led myself.
Winter's the place to raise your family. All the weather is cold and the vines here grow like plants. When I hear our choice, we'll make the best of it sounds. Through the loss of the human vibes and a memories.
In Windsor.
Folks from all over the U.S. and the world passed through on their way to see the Redwoods and on to Oregon. This, however, began to dwindle in 1962 when the freeway cut right to the town, connecting Santa Rosa to Healdsburg.
The ribbon-cutting ceremony was actually held in Windsor thanks to the WCIA, Windsor Community Improvement Association. Thanks to Ethel Kerr Brooks, Lorna Soderling, Donna Bertelsi, and Elsie Landris. This next song was the original poem written by Opal Garrett Young and was read at the November 1st, 1962 cutting ceremony at the Windsor Overpass.
The ribbon.
because they thought the taxes would be lower than paying at county level. It didn't fly. In 1982, they tried again.
Howdy, Edna. You've sure grown up pretty. I love hearing your voice at the telephone exchange. Windsor was its own water district and wanted control of its own school board, town council, and growth. They wanted Windsor residents to make their own decisions for Windsor. But not everyone agreed. Incorporating meant people had to get off septic and onto sewer.
Out of the way, Clara! You're always walking in the middle of the street.
This meant more expense and less control. Feeling grand.
Larger in corporate! Larger in corporate!
Oh my!
To Brooks Road South, and Jensen Lane to Path Dorada.
In the 80s, this ranch was divided up and sold. The Lakewood Shopping Center was built right at the Highway 101 Central Windsor exit. This became the new Windsor.
The Windsor Water District before it was incorporated on July 1st, 1992. Orrin Thiessen was commissioned by the City Council to plan the new old downtown over by the train station. The green opened the day after Father's Day 2000 to get it in. Finally, the core of Windsor had ceased swinging and come to a grand stop in the making of a lovely triangle of businesses and services that spread across Windsor and had the coolest downtown green that could be found in Sonoma County. I presently have the honor of being your town manager.
Now, all the while, Windsor was moving its center here, there, and everywhere. There were wonderful churches in Windsor that provided constant support to the community from the very beginning.
The first church in Windsor was an old log cabin on the Shiloh Cemetery property in 1853. It also doubled as the first school.
The churches of Windsor have embraced their role of nurturing the community,
physically, emotionally, and spiritually.
Our church organizations have led free vacation Bible schools, plays, and carnivals. They've raised money for schools, instruments, and even tutored.
Individual members of our local churches can be found doing good things everywhere.
But why do they do all that good stuff anyway?
Listen to the song and you'll find out.
I'm trying to
groups who provided an anchor for the spirit of our town as well. A group of women started the WCIA, the Windsor Community Improvement Association.
Gym was the middle school gym. A delegation from Japan came to see this model organization.
The WCIA received a $10,000 grant from them. John Espertozzi, one of our veterans, got the funds to make it happen and ran the baseball leagues. The Kaiser Park baseball fields were named Bertozzi Fields in honor of his efforts.
The Lions obtained a federal grant to buy land on Bull Castle Park. They sponsored the Halloween parade too.
On May 16, 1859, the Windsor Aquatics Club was chartered.
Hey, Rodney. Rodney Fields? This is Brenda from Healdsburg. I want you to expand Kiwanis into Windsor.
Why me?
Because you won't come down with your families and teachers from Healdsburg High. That's why.
True, true. Will the Healdsburg and the Santa Rosa clubs hear me out?
You bet. Our motto is serve all children, and that includes the children of Windsor.
Kiwanis had fun fundraisers, such as Catch It Bingo in Kaiser Park.
Three steer would be let loose on a giant bingo board in Kaiser Park, and whoever bought the square the cow pooped in won lots of money.
Bingo! I won!
It was a hilarious and lucrative event. Other activities included the Windsor Day Parade and selling Reese and See's candy to support children through the Windsor Service Alliance.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Rotary fence down behind bars.
Windsor Rotary Club, in conjunction with Santa Rosa Sunrise Club, held Rotary and the Slammer on October 25th, 1989, a fundraiser for RLP Regional Occupational Program. I'm Sheriff Dick Michelson, and I supervise this breakfast behind bars. Members were served convict coffee, hard times hash browns, midnight escape muffins, etc. We had a great time, and everyone was issued a volunteer sheriff's posse badge.
The ROP program used funds to build a huge grill and a very substantial trailer for honor prisoners to cook burgers, pancakes, etc. to make more money for their program. As a matter of fact, Windsor Rotary used it for years for Windsor Day's parade and festival, and we cooked burgers.
In the 1989 festival, I, Leslie Lewis, and Marie Coakley worked with the Windsor Chamber and the women of the Sonoma County Detention Center, blowing up balloons and placing them along the parade route. Marie and I had great times with the gals, and we truly enjoyed helping our parade committee, although we had to keep a close eye on them, and we freaking come to the tanks.
Park is my middle name. I built the first business park in Windsor. I began in 1981, before the town was incorporated. The business park has been renamed by the businessman in the park to Randall Lewis Business Park with an E. I told you, Park is my middle name. There are some very large businesses in the park, a big financial taboo to the Windsor. I was a pioneer who saw the potential of Windsor.
Donated the money for the stage on the town green. The Rotary built our fantastic skate park. The Knights of Columbus contribute to our community regularly through distributing food and helping the widows and fatherless, as they have been since 1882. Through Optimist, Clipwings, Shriners, Masons, too many organizations to mention them all, but all of them are filled with wonderful men and women who sacrifice time and energy to bless the lives of the people of Windsor.
I love a service club, yes I do. I love a service club.
Team and a baseball team.
They got cement forms from the Highway 101 construction contractors and built a backstop and a baseball diamond behind Polly's Market.
When this group dissolved, John Bertozzi started the Babe Ruth League and the Boys Club, which later became the Boys and Girls Club.
Shiloh Cemetery that doubled as a church on Sundays. It was used from 1853 to 1863 and led by me, John Pruitt, and my wife, Betty Brooks. In 1866, there was a schoolhouse by the well by Old Redwood Highway. From that time forward, Windsor added more and more schools to meet the needs of their growing population. In April of 1992, Windsor voted to unify their schools, and the Windsor Unified School District was born.
In the olden days, Windsor students were bused up to Healdsburg. When the first Windsor High School was built, it stopped the notion that Windsor kids had to leave Windsor to start their education. When this happened, students were able to finish kindergarten through 12th grade.
Windsor also boasts homeschooling families, private schools, and the district sponsors three charter schools that provide unique services to address the needs of every family. Cali Kameka Language Academy is a Spanish-emergent K-8 charter The Village is a K-8 charter that teaches its academics through multi-age classes, art, and nature. Insight Charter provides excellent academic services for teenagers. All of our schools score well in the state. For such a small town, Windsor has a lot of academic choices for their children, as well as art and music opportunities at most grade levels.
Windsor families are grateful to the support groups who keep our schools running and who model with their behavior how to keep the children first. Boosters at the middle school and high school, C-Star, PTA, the Windsor's Ed Foundation, Project Grad, Windsor Advocates for Music, and our beloved volunteer coordinators at each campus. So while Windsor grown-ups strive to work out what constitutes as a good education, the children of Windsor dutifully flow through the classroom, and over the decades, their views of school haven't changed much.
Above is a space below. I love and respect all the good people that in love
4 years before he was killed in a tragic automobile accident.
Rudy taught Spanish at the junior high and also taught driver education to both students and adults. Clarence Renovera, principal of the junior high, remembered Rudy had a great influence on the students and acted as liaison between the schools, community, and the Mexican-American youngsters.
Over 400 signatures were on a petition to have the gymnasium named in his honor at the newly constructed junior high in Windsor. Mr. Huerta was scheduled to be a teacher and counselor at the new school.
The gym was named Rudy Huerta Gymnasium by the unanimous vote of the Board of Trustees in October of 1970.
Thank you.
eucalyptus tree actually absorbs pollutants out of the air and stores it in its leaves. Trees give us food, shelter, rubber, clothes, and much more. The symbol of Windsor is the oak tree. How appropriate for a city that produces people such as George Briant.
There are 9 to 10 sycamore trees on Jensen Lane, Lakewood Drive, Old Redwood Highway, and Henry Lane that George Griot planted over 60 years ago. That land was the original Duvander Ranch. He planted all those trees so that each house built during development could have a tree in its front yard.
Then there are people like Lisa Ellsbury, Bob Crawford, and Karen Alves, whose hearts were as big as the oaks.
They have dedicated much time, resources, and energy to the preservation of historic trees in our town and county.
Are these the trees they want you to down?
Yeah, messes up the whole look of the neighborhood. The trees we'll be putting in are so small and scrawny looking compared to these guys.
I don't care why. I'm just doing my job. Are these the trees we're supposed to cut down? To that plan where you are?
Yeah, these are the trees.
Wait, stop! Stop! What are you doing? Those trees were planted by the McClellan family in honor of Clara McClellan's birth in the 1870s. You're just gonna chop it down?
Look, it's my job. I'm just doing what I'm supposed to do.
Those trees line the original driveway that led to the Robert Cunningham Pioneer House. Doesn't it fill you with a sort of awe and wonder as you imagine their little buggies going down the driveway to what is now the old Henry House? And you want Foxwood Drive to cut straight through it? Isn't there a way we could have your development and the trees?
Well, it's gonna take a lot of time and effort.
Well, I've got a lot of time and energy to help you boys figure it out.
Well, dang it, woman, trees can't be more important than people. We're planting trees with every house that we build. Isn't that good enough for you?
Trees are not more important than people, but they are important. And if there's any way we can keep these beautiful and historic trees, we must.
I've got other stuff I can do. Let's talk to the boss about this.
Oh, thank you, gentlemen.
Wait, stop! Stop!
Distance, they had to travel on the unlit roads.
Speaking of our
the Green was dedicated in 2000. Together, the Green and the Market were deemed as the best things that happened in Windsor.
Oh, if you are a person who was separated, then you had to take the farmer of the person that you thought all the farmers had started. So the farmers of the farmers are part of the game. Farmers of the farmers is the farmers in the trees. Farmers of the farmers is the keeper for the bees. If you want to eat the wall of the farmer, don't be strange. And also thank the farmers for starting up the grain. Turn it to the green on Thursday or Sunday. By improvement, you set to buy a fish that's in land.
Indeed, the very generous Admiral Sparks donated the funds to build the stage on the green, a wonderful gift to the whole town. Marv Stubbs, a Vietnam veteran, was a school board member, a charter member of Qantas, kept the Veterans of Foreign Wars going by serving the families of veterans, and indeed was the heart that drove the machine that led Windsor to incorporate into a town. He's considered by many to be the father of Windsor. Walter Agin, a very important man in Windsor, served in the Navy during World War II, was a teacher and principal in Windsor and Healdsburg, and was Sonoma County Superintendent of Schools. Indeed. Another Windsor veteran who served in the Navy during World War II was Sam Lawson. Sam grew up in Windsor and also became a teacher and principal, but alas, not in our area. John S. Bartozzi, a veteran who was the president of ACORN, a group which recognized great servants of Windsor and put their names on the wall in the Shiloh Cemetery. The first burial in our Shiloh Cemetery was in 1850, a Laughlin infant. And it is also the resting place for veterans dating back as far as the Civil War. Veterans have dedicated buildings and flagpoles and continue to serve in our community long after the service. Now I put it to you, to serve or not to serve? Is that even a question? Now I would like to ask all veterans to please stand and be recognized during the next song. Please stand.
If you love you
Council realized that Windsor needed a volunteer fire department. He contacted Vic Posey, who had been a firefighter for 7 years before coming to Windsor. He was a very capable man and a very funny man.
Once he had one of his cars painted purple, just for fun. It was the talk of town for a long time. He also enjoyed singing and dancing, and was a real hoot.
Vic continued to serve Windsor for 45 years afterwards. The biggest question on Vic and Dick's mind was,
how are we gonna do it?
How are we gonna do it? How are we gonna do it?
All this worn out equipment needs repairing.
How are we gonna do it? How are we gonna do it?
I work on them all night just so they're usable by morning.
How are we gonna do it? How are we gonna do it?
I have an old road oiler. I'll make a tender out of it.
How are we gonna do it? How are we gonna do it?
Put a new pump on it.
That won't work.
It will. You just can't let it get to you.
How are we gonna do it? How are we gonna do it?
Then we need money for equipment.
How are we gonna do it? How are we gonna do it?
We'll have a party and a lip sync. The folks will pay for that.
Okay.
So please join us in singing the Windsor song. Again, the words are right over here, and they'll do their bows to you guys being their backup singers. All right, go ahead, band.